Shavua Tov, everyone. Jumping right into it. Hashem is so kind. You know, you would think now it's Teves, it's dark. Okay, we're going to have to, I mentioned that there's 8 weeks to Purim. Maybe that'll give people a little bit of chizuk. But still, it's 8 weeks away. And Rabbi Hashem says, no, there's a concept called Shevivim. I don't know how many of you, when you grew up, you knew anything about Shevivim. But Shevivim is an incredible opportunity. It's 8 weeks, 6 weeks. It could be taka, if it's a muberes tat, then it'll be 8 weeks. 6 weeks of incredible opportunity of avodas Hashem. It stands for Shmois, Vayera, Boy, Beshalach, Yisroi, and Mishpatim, which are the 6 weeks called Shevivim, based on the pasuk in Yirmiyahu, Shuvu Banim Shevivim. When I was growing up in Eretz Yisrael, if the teacher had to tell you that you're mischievous, or you had to tell the parent that the child is mischievous, you were called a shovav. And a shovav wasn't such a bad thing. Shovav was basically a mischievous, but it was almost with a little bit of a tip of love. A shovav is a troublemaker, but a sweet troublemaker. The Rabban Hashem says, Shuvu banim shovivim, even if you feel like, oh gosh, I'm already out, you know, Sukkot was gevaldik, Chanukah was also maybe special, but now how am I going to make it? The Rabban Hashem says, 6 weeks, which I'll be the Zohar and I'll be Kabbalah, are weeks where we could be Mesaken, I mean, we could fix Chet Adam HaRishon. The first week in Mitzrayim, all the suffering in Mitzrayim was Mesaken, was fixing Chet Adam HaRishon. And it really is based on the spheres, without going very deep into the spheres, simple, the Chesed, Gvur, Tiferes, Netzach, Hod, Yesod, and Malchus, which is actually also corresponds to each day of the week. We start off today, Sunday is Chesed, all the way up to the sixth day, which is Yesod, and then, which is the Tikkun HaBris, Keneged HaBris, and then seven, the Shabbos is always Malchus, Peh. So, this week starts this whole experience of the six weeks of Shevivim. And it's based on the Rabban Shem telling us, you could return, you never give up, you could be a Shovav, you could be called a mischievous, you could be called an ADD, you could be called a lot of terms. The Rabban Shem gives us an opportunity to start over. And not just to start over, these are weeks where a person could mamash fix such deep chatoim and sins and everything else. Api Kabbalah, I can't even tell you enough about it, but what you see written, and this is not so, I didn't grow up with it either, maybe Reb Benji, because he's Hasidic, so he heard about these musagim, but they're very deep, and it's an opportunity. In fact, the minig is to fast Thursdays. Really, the minig was to fast Fridays. Why? Because Friday is connected to Yesod. But since you're not supposed to go into Shabbos Mu'una, so there was different customs. Some actually would fast on Friday, but would eat right before Shabbos. Some would actually fast into Shabbos. But we made it, to make it simple, they made it on Thursday. And therefore, so the minig is by many. In fact, I saw I think it was a Klausenberger, he would actually fast. I have 10 people fasting. They would say, Vayechal, they made it mamish a whole. So 6 weeks of tshuva. So we can't say that Rabban Shem doesn't give us opportunity. So we have to thank Hashem. And we're starting this mamish today. This is the first of the 6 weeks. And grab the opportunity. Hatzlach rabba to everyone.